sure are funny little britches.
Ourselves as the Barbies. And I am Timeless Barbie from the 60s. And this would be Miss Sporty Barbie. And of course, this would be our gorgeous
glitter.
Glamour Glitter Barbie. Every girl should have a Barbie party. And this is our celebration of Barbie. Now.
Oh, I
need my. Oh, yeah. Okay. Oh, and we have things to hand out. What?
I've never seen you, so. what should we say?
Yes.
Barbie.
You know? Barbie-ish, yes.
Barbie-ish. Well, you know, there's an image.
You're beautiful.
All image right. To hold up.
We have a song that we would like for everyone to participate in. And so we're going to teach you the chorus. And then you'll choose a partner. And so I'm going to pass these out. And whoops, so you'll have the words.
I can't sing.
Okay, well then you don't have to sing.
You can stand back and enjoy the
moment. That's right. There you go.
I'm so glad they put out those candles because we're a little flammable.
Okay. Now, does everybody remember this song? It goes, my mother told me if I was goody that she would buy me a rubber Barbie. My auntie told her, I kissed a soldier. Now she won't buy me a rubber Barbie.
Listening.
Oh.
Oh, my. Oh, Lord. This is too hot.
Okay. All right. Oh. You're in here.
Yeah. Wanda.
Why are you here, Eleanor?
Yeah.
Is Angie coming?
Is no, I didn't get a hold of
Angie.
Like
9 o'clock.
Oh, really? I hope she didn't feel the point.
No, she is.
That's what happened. She's probably glad we met her.
No, she has.
The big ones
are. I feel better today.
Oh, look, she's got one on her side. I bought it. Oh, thank you, Gail. You think it's fresh?
Oh, that's what I'm trying.
I said that was preschool, that graduation.
Well, they got pictures out of here.
Yeah.
He loves all of you so very much, and we're really glad that you could come and be in our home, and we hope it won't be the last time you do it. Okay? Anytime, you're welcome.
Go away from me.
Happy birthday, Daddy. Happy birthday.
Let us know when dinner's ready.
And they said, just let us know when dinner's ready, and I don't cook anymore.
For time since I've known Eldon that if I asked for something or his help or something, that he would do it. And give me stuff, you know, and go cut things off the trees and even give me sticks out in the backyard that I want. I'm one of the few people that like sticks. And so he just
never
one of those
any
kind of,
money. Don't ever ask
no,
for
well,
that.
You know. I know my limits, yeah. But he just always been, since I've known him, one of those fellas that's always willing to help somebody else and give something back. And so this is a song that I heard a little while back, and a little while back, that sounded okey, didn't it? But it's maybe kind of about some lessons that we need to learn about giving things back. We're all pretty blessed in here to have some luxuries in life and some things and stuff, call it stuff. And maybe sometimes we need to remember where we get that, and this is kind of an old song. It's called Give a Little Bit Back.
Sometimes I close my eyes and see a field of corn from long ago. Little sister, daddy, mom, me, working side by side, row by row. Golden tassels waving tall, we'd fill our sacks at harvest time. I can still hear Daddy call, leave one behind, leave some behind. Give a little bit back, oh. what you've been given. Leave a little behind for those with none. It's the law of plenty and the law of living to keep what you've got and give a little bit back.
Try that again.
And every year, wild geese flew right to that field at harvest time. Somehow they always knew that he seasons change and young girls grow and roll away on morning trains. I'll wave goodbye, how could I know? I'd never look in daddy's eyes again. Today I met a ragged man who asked if I could spare a dime. I placed a dollar in his hand as daddy's words rang through my mind. Give a little bit back of what you've been given. Leave a little behind for those with none. It's the law of plenty and the lesson in living to keep what you've got and give a little bit back. Oh, give a little bit back of what you've been given. Leave a little behind for those with none. And a lesson in living to keep what you've got and give a little bit back.
Don't realize how much information our grandpas have. They know a lot because they've been around a long, long time. A long, long, long time.
Amen.
So sometimes, you know, we need to kind of listen to their stories and some of the things they talk to us about, because they really do have a lot of good information, you know. Because they didn't get this old, you know, by making mistakes over and over the same time. So they made all the mistakes, so if all you could do is just kind of listen, then you might learn something, you know? Sometimes I still learn stuff. This is called Grandpa. Grandpa,
tell me about the good old days. Sometimes it seems like world's gone crazy. Grandpa, take me back to yesterday, when the line between right and wrong didn't feel so far away. Grandpa, everything is changing fast. Some call it progress. I just don't know. truly fall in love to stay. Stand beside each other, come what may. Was a promise really something people have kept? Not just something they would say and then forget. Families really bow their heads to pray. The daddies really never go away. And oh, Grandpa, tell me about the good old days.
Grandpa,
tell me about the good old days. Sometimes it seems like this world's gone crazy. Wander back into the past and paint me a picture of a time so long ago. Did lovers really fall in love to stay? Stand beside each other, come what may. Was a promise really something people would get? Not just something they would say and then forget. Families really bow their heads to pray. The daddies really never go away. And oh, Grandpa, tell me about the good old days. And oh, Grandpa, tell me about the good old days.
You still frosted in there?
That's pretty good, Dad.
Everybody say the card I got.
You want a fancy fork, huh? Okay. I bet you take the silver tip back. Your grandpa.
Go! Land, some we're having this big hoopla where we get to have fun.
He says, oh, I'm leaving.
We use it as an excuse to get together for Brian's birthday, so we sing
happy
Nice. What year is it?
It's 1999. It's the last Christmas of this century. Of this whatever.
It's real light.
It's a real long time.
Thank you, Miss. It's real light.
It's Jesus' 2000th birthday. I hope you like that.
I do. Yeah, it's great.
That was something you hadn't asked for, so I thought it.
I just wish we knew her.
Well, I might put pictures of that. I guess we'll take it. I love that.
Pictures
of
what?
I'm gonna tell people this is one of my relatives.
Uh-huh. This is my great aunt.
This is my great aunt who wrote Equestrian.
She was a great aunt.
They're really neat pictures.
Somebody's aunt, not mine, but she was great. Ta-da.
Scale, shit. Not fair.
So nice. Kind of like baseball.
Uh-huh. That's good. At least I got that on tape. Do you have any other words of wisdom?
I thought you were just taking a picture.
All right.
Well, hold that in.
Here's another one for Mom.
From now we'll be playing that back. And
Mom's
saying
in a skinny
little spirit. Mom drinking that day or
what? She can hold the whiskey next to you.
Yeah, she was drinking this whiskey.
Oh, yay!
Does everybody know that I'm the only one who gets this for you? Why doesn't anybody else buy it? I'm surprised that you can get two or three to read it.
What is it?
Because it's tradition for you to get them for me.
Well, you tell everybody that's what you want.
No.
Oh, just me.
But is there any kind of a pencil?
There's mine.
Shouldn't have to ask for one. You just know that I want one every year.
I know.
Every year, just know. I wish they would make a bigger version.
Well, maybe they alternate every year or something. Dog, different size.
There you go. Yeah,
those are great.
Mm-hmm. They're neat looking.
They're comfortable.
If you think you're too big, then I'll give
you
a
Well, I don't think it really matters if you're too big. I mean, it's not like you're going to be walking around.
Go outside and stuff. I just thought those were great.
Those are nice. My feet just get cold walking around. Mm-hmm.
high mountains. They're rock climbing.
I've got some to do that polar fleece, but they get dog hair all over them. Yeah. Thank you.
Never had
them. Now you do.
Thank you.
You're all decked out for casual wear.
Mm-hmm. Sewing both hips.
Is this from the same pottery place?
It's not a pottery. It's from the ceramics department.
Sale. Yeah,
from the same. They have hundreds of people buying stuff.
Aren't those
I've never
pretty?
Been to it. I went for the first time this year.
They're beautiful.
Nice.
At where now?
At the Art Institute, the ceramics department. They have they make like $40,000 in a weekend.
Wow.
I mean, it's all functional stuff, you know.
Yeah.
This is time people want to buy vases or plates.
When did they have this sale?
I think it was a couple weeks ago. First week in December.
Really? I'll have to make an appointment maybe next year
to
come up because I have. Those are so pretty.
Pretty crowded?
Well, on Saturday morning, yeah, there's a line out.
Wow.
100 people waiting in line to get in. The best stuff you should.
Oh, that is sharp. Oh, that looks so good on you.
Wow, thank you. This is so great.
That looks so good on you.
Thank you.
The J. Crew guy. You're a J. Crew guy now.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Is that Dad's gift? The doggy one? Is there another?
The doggy one.
That big one there. Right there. Oh, yay!
Oh, boy.
I figured this might be something easy for you to shop for. Yeah, got me a new sport watch. Yes. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I like this.
You do?
Yeah, I do.
Yes. That'd probably be better than water. I don't know.
The rubber was okay, but.
Well, I can put the band on that one. Isn't that in the glow?
Yeah. Yeah, that's great. Oh, yeah, that's great. But it's a boy watch. It says Iron Man. It's not an Iron Woman.
Uh-huh. The other one says that, too. I rap pretty good, huh?
Yeah, you did good on this one. This is where you used all the paper. Well, I'll be darned. Cowgirl. Can't do one of these either, so I just have to pretend.
He's always getting cowboy books and here.
Want to be everything, but
got a calendar needs.
I know it says a free one.
Well, nothing free. But
that's what it says.
Uh-huh. That's marketing.
And we get them every year, and I bought two of them, and they are the best cookbooks ever. Mm-hmm. So that real big.